In today's video, I'm going to offer you two important things. The first is permission to be angry with your ex-wife. And the second are some tools to keep that anger at a healthy level, to manage it so that it works for you and not against you. First off, I just want to come right out and say it, you guys. It's fine to be angry. It's okay to be mad. So often men are told that their anger isn't okay, that it's not acceptable. And this is such a detrimental thing to believe about anger. It causes us to stifle our anger, to hide it, to buffer and distract and numb out with alcohol and drugs and gambling and shopping and food. It is not healthy to try to ignore or shut down your anger. Anger is there for a reason. It has a positive intention always, even if it doesn't help you achieve that positive intention. And in some cases, after a divorce, it's actually really good for you to be mad at your ex. For instance, anger can be incredibly motivating. It can help lift you up out of depression or despair that often comes along after divorce. So many men I talk to feel completely broken down by their divorce, and they internalize so many of the things that their ex said or that their therapist said or that society tells them, and they start to believe that they're a bad person, that they're a narcissist, that they're an asshole, that there's somehow something just inherently wrong with them. I've even had men use the word evil. Maybe I'm just evil. Maybe I'm just bad. Maybe there's just something broken in me. When you start to believe those things after yourself, which is really common after divorce, it is awful. It is painful. It is heavy and it feels hopeless, because if there's something fundamentally wrong with you, what's the point? Why even try? Anger is an incredibly powerful and effective motivator to move you out of that place of despair and into a place of action. In that case, anger can be really healthy after divorce. It can help you go out and seek support. It can help you go out and connect to people and find new experiences and start to move forward with your life. However, you don't want to stay in anger for too long. Honestly, it just takes an awful lot of energy. So as much as it can motivate you, as much as that initial burst of anger can give you energy and get you up out of depression or out of despair or self-loathing, anger also takes an incredible amount of energy to sustain. I'm going to give you some tools to help you harness the power of that initial burst of anger without getting stuck in that sustained anger that is just an energy suck. The way that you harness the power of anger for good is to initially let it happen. And this might feel really uncomfortable if you have been controlling or managing your anger for a long time. So I would recommend that you do this when you have some space and some time to yourself, even if it's just 5 or 10 minutes. The way that you let that anger out, the way that you experience that anger, is by feeling it in your body. Anger, like any emotion, is just a set of physical sensations in your body. So you tune in, you pay attention. When you feel that anger rising, you notice what you're feeling. How does it feel in your chest, in your arms, in your face, in your neck, in your stomach? Maybe you feel a sensation throughout your whole body. A lot of times anger brings a tightness or a tension or a heat. It can elevate your heart rate. It can increase your breathing. Some people even feel the sensation of like a red ball somewhere in their body that's moving. Bring your awareness to the physical sensations of anger. And because anger is an emotion and it is physical, it can also be helpful to allow yourself to express it in a physical fashion. I don't mean punching a wall or attacking your ex or doing something violent. I mean, letting your physical body move naturally with that anger. Maybe you growl, maybe you yell, maybe you stomp your feet. Let yourself feel it. There's one important thing that you're not going to do. You are going to feel your anger, but you are not going to feed it. The way you feed anger is by spiraling your thoughts. So the anger comes up, there's an initial trigger and you feel the anger. And what most of us do is we jump on that anger bandwagon and we feed it. We think of all of the ways that she was horrible in the past, all of the things she's doing, we think of every single flaw. And we get sucked up. This is how anger gets sustained. We get sucked up in the storytelling that not only keeps the anger alive, but keeps it building. And this is incredibly exhausting. It is an energy sucking practice. Don't do it. Your energy is so much better spent in so many other ways. Do you really want to waste more energy on your ex-wife? No, don't give her that power. Don't give the past that power. Do not feed your anger with a stream of thoughts. And I know that's easier said than done, right? How do you stop those thoughts from coming up? This is something that I can help you with in coaching, but I'm going to give you kind of the big overview of it right now. You have a lot of voices in your brain, a lot of inputs. You probably have felt conflicted at times in your divorce. I imagine this even comes up when you feel angry, because there's part of you that's angry and there's part of you that's like, I shouldn't be angry. And then somewhere in there, there's you underneath all of that. And who knows what you really want, because these other voices get so loud. So part of managing your anger and not sustaining it, not letting it build, is identifying and getting to know the parts of you that are angry, right? And yes, this is just you. But it's helpful to think of it as a separate part, because then you can work with that anger directly. You can find out what it wants for you, what its positive intention is. You can help that part of you see how much energy it takes to sustain that anger and see if maybe it's not actually helping you achieve that intention. But if the anger wants you to be justified, if it wants you to feel safe, if it wants you to get love, whatever that anger ultimately wants for you, is getting wrapped up in these thoughts and perpetuating and building the anger in your brain with your mental stories, is that helping you achieve that goal? Most of the time it isn't. By working directly with that part and starting to shift that, starting to help the angry part itself see how anger is not always serving you, you can get it under control. You can start to regulate and manage that part of yourself, which lets you take control of those mental stories. It lets you slow down that anger feeding thought pattern. So then when you feel that initial burst of anger come up, you can use it, right? You can say, yes, okay, this is better than the hopelessness. This is better than despair and depression. You can let yourself feel it fully by bringing your awareness to the physical sensations and letting it actually process through your body. That's going to help move you out of some of those stages of grief and loss and self-doubt that can be really demoralizing and really unmotivating. So that initial burst, all you have to do is feel it and pay attention to it and allow it to pass through you. And then you've got to get on board with that inner angry part that wants to keep it going and sustain it and feed it and drive it, and recognize that feeding that anger is actually not a good use of that energy that you just harnessed by feeling the anger in the first place. I know this is kind of a big overview of how to work with anger. The specifics vary case by case, person by person. Getting to know your anger and what it's doing for you and the ways it might be working against you takes a little bit more one-on-one attention and a little bit more internal digging. So this is the broad view. If you would like help exploring this topic for yourself and understanding step-by-step how to actually do this, how to work with your anger so that you can get its benefits without suffering from the negatives that come along with sustained anger, book a free strategy session with me. Let's talk about your specific situation and see if coaching might be a good fit to help you move through not only your anger, but all of the other difficult and painful emotions that come up after a divorce. If this video was helpful, as always, please like, please subscribe. I can't wait to see you in the next video.